My name's Paul Roberts. I'm a technical specialist at Microsoft, working with the Defender for IoT platform. This is a short video to walk through the process of creating a risk assessment report, but also the tuning that is involved on the platform prior to going through that process. If we start at the top of the menu on the left-hand side and we look at the alerts section, now this is a demonstration platform, so there are a large number of alerts in here. But typically, we want to reduce the amount of alerts, and that doesn't just mean acknowledging them, but we need to make sure that they're not service impacting in any way. So these alerts should be investigated and cleared prior to creating the risk assessment report. One of the other things we need to do is, under system settings, we need to look at the subnets to ensure that the subnets are configured correctly. The platform works on the basis that any private address is considered internal and any public address is considered external or internet. So if any public addresses are being used inside the environment, we need to make sure that they're added in here, because otherwise we're going to start generating alerts that say we found internet connectivity. The other thing we need to ensure is where we've discovered Windows devices, as an example, that we've either used WMI to gather the patch information and the security information on that platform, or we need to go into the data mining section, and under CVEs, we need to ensure that we delete any CVE that's been applied to that device that we know is irrelevant. Once we've done this, we can go into the risk assessment section and we can click generate report. And the platform will automatically create a risk assessment report. Now, this takes about 3 or 4 minutes, so to speed up the process, I created one earlier. So click on the link, we download the risk assessment report, and then open it up in our web browser. Now, you can see, obviously, I haven't tuned my platform, so I've got a pretty poor security score of 39% overall. And as we go through this, you'll see that we start with a summary of what's been discovered and what's causing this score. But as we go further through the report, the details get more and more. We're given its explicit information around why this score is so low. So in this example, I've got 42 devices that the platform has deemed as vulnerable. I've got 26 devices that need improvement, either by updating the software or adding additional patches. And overall, I've got 123 secure devices. Now, as we go through, you can see even on this summary, we've got 34 internet connections. So if any of those networks that we're connecting to are internal but have public IP addresses, this is going to cause us an issue in this risk assessment report. So in this case, I've also got 33 connections between ICS subnets. I've not loaded any firewall rules onto the platform, so we're not able to use the platform to investigate whether they're relevant or whether they need tuning. I've got 7 devices that are accessible remotely. I've got 1 scanning device, and we've also included 3 of the top attack vectors that the platform has generated. So scrolling through, we have a table of contents. And we start with device security. So this is going to list the devices that we've found on the platform by vendor, how many of them are there, and what's the typical security score range. So as an example, if I use the Rockwell Automation as an example, I've got 19 of those devices, and the security score is between 32% and 100%. And as we scroll through this, you'll see more summarization. So in this case, the next one is the attack vectors and what is their security score or their vulnerability score. We've got what are the network risks that we found. So I've already mentioned the internet connections. I've got the connections in between the ICS subnets. I've also got access points, malware indicators, and wireless access points. Then we've got network operational issues. And what mitigation steps we should take to resolve the problems that we've found and ultimately to increase our security score. Now, again, this part of the risk assessment document is purely a summary. As we go further through, there's some explanation around what the risk assessment is for and how it's derived. We've got a glossary of terms that are used. And then ultimately we get on to the devices themselves. So this is where it becomes very important to understand, you know, what patch level the Windows devices specifically are at. So here, for example, I've got a Windows 7 machine, and I've had to assume, because I have no other information, that this device isn't patched. And this is why it's got such a low security score. So we've aligned all of the known CVEs that we have against that machine and against what we know about it. Going further through, we have a Windows server. The same applies. We don't know what the patch level is, so we have to assume the worst. And then we start on the PLCs themselves. So here, for example, I've got a Siemens PLC, and you can see it's got one unacknowledged alert against it, which is going to impact the security score of this device. However, as we scroll down, we can also see that there are a large number of CVEs associated with this device. So that goes some way to explaining why we've aligned such a low security score to it. And as we go further through, we've got additional PLCs. So in this case, this one's from Rockwell. It's got a similar security score. And again, we've got an unacknowledged alert leveraged against it, and we have a list of CVEs. And this list will go on for quite some pages, just given the amount of assets that I've got on my platform. But finally, we get down to some of the additional information. So I've already mentioned the connections between ICS networks. So we need to verify that these are valid and these should be happening. We've got industrial malware indicators. Now, these are detected over the last 30 days. So even if I cleared all of these today and ran the report again, these indicators would still stay there because obviously we need to know and understand the impact that these have had. We've got no unauthorized devices. So my platform is still in learning mode. Therefore, any additional device that's found will just get added to the inventory automatically. We've got the access points that we found on the network and whether they're wireless enabled or not. So going through this to get an understanding of what we found in the environment is going to help understand if there's any rogue devices or rogue routers or access points on our network. Again, I've not uploaded any firewall rules, so the platform was unable to assess those. And here we get down to the internet connectivity. So these are all the connections that the platform has discovered from internal devices going out to the internet. So again, these need to be looked into as they present quite a high security risk. We also list out the protocol issues that we found on the network, and that could be protocol failures, so RPC operation failures, or it could be events that have happened, so PLC stop commands being sent, etc. So again, all of this needs investigating. We're listing out the top protocol volumes that we've seen across the sensor. Any disconnections that we've seen, so two devices talking to each other that get disconnected, we need to look into this and understand what's happening. We list out the IP networks that we found and the number of devices that are within those IP subnets. Then we have the attack vectors, so the top three attack vectors in this case, and we list out exactly what the steps are and what's happened to cause that. And then finally, at the bottom, we have the more detailed mitigation steps. So in this case, we can see that if we address the internet connections and we stop that from happening, then my security score is going to increase by an additional 15%. So it started at 39%. It's going to increase to 54%. Likewise, adding antivirus, installing security updates, investigating the malware indicators that we've discovered on the network, updating firmware, and looking at unacknowledged alerts as well. So all of these are going to have an impact ultimately to the security score that the platform is giving this environment. And these security scores can then be taken in conjunction with other information coming either from the center or from other places within the environment and put together to address and assess adherence to regulatory compliance, as an example. So I hope you found this video useful. Thank you very much for listening.